right, guys, we are on one where she says it leaks water when she turns it off, and it's an upflow in a closet. I'm outside checking pressures. It does seem to be a little bit low, but it is not freezing up, and it's kind of cool out here. I'm gonna take you inside, and we're gonna look at the coil and the drain pan. And see if it drips. I'm waiting for that blower to shut off. No, ma'am, it didn't leak. At least not yet.
Well, that's where it's been leaking from.
Well, you said it was leaking when it shuts off?
Right.
All right, we're doing a leak search on this coil to see if we have a leak in here. With this particular leak detector, it helps if you go slow. I'm seeing oil right here. Thank you. have a joint right here. Looks like it's got some oil on it. I'm fixing to search that a little better. I'm up to 14. I think we're getting closer.
All right, guys, the reason I was focusing on a leak search was because, well, there are two things that can make water drip off the coil when the air handler shuts down. If it's dirty, it can drip off the coil. The air flowing up will help hold it on the coil. But normally, if it's dirty like that, it will drip normally all the time. But if it's just dripping when it turns off, I suspect that there's a circuit in that coil that is not as cold as the rest, and when water starts to run down, it will drip. And sometimes it'll do that when it shuts off, or sometimes it'll do that all the time. It can be a restricted coil, or it can be a circuit that just isn't as cold as the rest. So that's why I focused on a leak search on that one. I spoke with the customer, and considering the fact that it needs to be pulled and cleaned and we have a leak to repair, we're likely going with a whole new coil. So my efforts were well worth it. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to tune in tomorrow because I have another hack job to show you. Catch you tomorrow. Like.